Breeze and I were tagging. We were Hollywood Express, and our thing was to throw out glow sticks and wear these crazy colors and stuff. And we're wrestling you guys.
Harps and Rowan.
So our entrance is taken forever. So you guys were out first. And I remember you're standing there just like ready to fight. Harper looks at us. He goes, "Get in the ring. We never get time to wrestle. And you're cutting into it." And I was like, "Oh, that was the first time that I had wrestled him." And
oh my God.
Just hilarious. Just a good time.
Well, I always think too, like, man, when I think of Brody's last 8 years, I always think of Rowan.
WWE Universe, this is what nightmares are made of. Harper and Rowan, nearly 600 pounds of bad intentions.
Because even when you two would be separated or you'd have solo runs, it was always, you guys were like magnets, man. You guys always came back to each other. And I love like the true feeling. Like it really touched me. I can't remember when, but you had this great moment, Rowan, and Brody put on Instagram just this long, like, he really believed in you, man. And he was so proud to see you, to step out on your own, to see your growth, not as a man, not only as a man, but as a performer, like both. He was so proud of your personal and career growth. And that's something that I'll always remember and treasure, and just the real love that you two had for each other. And I was just so moved by Joe, what you did to honor him, and the love that you have for Brody. So I just wanted to thank you, one, for being open enough and vulnerable enough to let people know how much he meant to you. And I'm just proud of you for doing that. So I just want to say thank you. And I always think back to you guys as like brothers, man. A lot of people are partnered together, but you guys felt like brothers to me.
Mm-hmm. But you know, it's funny. We all had a different relationship with him, but you know, to me, it really did feel like a brother. Because you know, in the beginning there, and you guys can attest, most of you guys were in FCW with us. We butt heads. For whatever reason, we butt heads. And I, looking back, maybe it's because we were just a little bit too alike. But we always had respect and admiration for each other. And we always wanted the best for each other. You say we were like glue, but always like that came back together. We always wanted to be off on our own, but we always got back together. And even when he left the company, he'd say nice things about me. When he left the company, I would say nice things about him. I'd go out of my way to contact him, watch his matches, just anything. And one thing I don't think he really knew, and you talk about growing as a man, and just by seeing how he treated his family, his kids, and how much love they had for each other. I was in a dark place halfway through my run on the roster with you guys. And I was depressed. I was going through a divorce. I wasn't the best dad. And if you want to be a better guy, all around, look for the best people. And I took that from him. You can talk about the wrestling and all that. Yes, he made me want to improve and all that. But this is life. And in life, he makes me you want to improve. He makes you want to be the best man you can be. And because of that, I'm in a so much better place in my life with my wife, with my kids. And I live and I breathe for them. And I live and breathe for relationships like you guys, who I still talk to. And it's not just because of this. Like, I still talk to you guys. I love all of you. And the fact that we're doing this and we're talking about them, as much as it hurts, you know, you can take out a positive from what he did while he was here in the short time he was here. Because he did so much good. And he doesn't even know it. He didn't even know it, how much good he did to individuals. I've talked to so many different people that have met him for like an hour. They took are just meeting this lovely, bright soul just for a minute. How he touched life. It's incredible. I don't think I've heard of anybody, especially in the wrestling business, that's touched so many people so short amount of time in his life. And it just warms my heart. I don't think he'd be making fun of me for that one. I think he'd have a little smile and smirk. He'd probably pat himself on the back, put himself over.
Yeah, there you go.
That was Brody. Yeah.
Oh. He'd say, yeah, I knew you liked me.
Yeah.
Do you want more? Of course you do. Follow the podcast on Spotify and feel the power.